वेलकम टू आईएससी प्लस वन हिस्ट्री क्लास. वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लेसन फोर टुडे, प्रोटेस्ट मूवमेंट अगेंस्ट कलोनियल रूल. बिफोर गोइंग थ्रू द टॉपिक, वी विल गो थ्रू द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द लेसन. द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स आर टू नो अबाउट इंडो अपराइजिंग ऑफ 1859, टू डिस्कस डेक्कन राइट्स ऑफ 1875, एंड टू डिस्कस द मुंडा अपराइजिंग ऑफ 1899 टू 1900. इन दिस सेशन वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द इंडिगो अपराइजिंग ऑफ 1859 एंड डेक्कन राइट्स ऑफ 1875. बिफोर गोइंग अहेड, वी विल डिस्कस द न्यू टर्म्स ऑफ दिस लेसन. इंडिगो, डीप ब्लू कलर डाई, और इन हिंदी इट इज़ कॉल्ड एज नील. इट वॉज यूज फॉर कलरिंग कॉटन फैब्रिक इन इंग्लैंड. टिरनी, द क्रूअल एंड अनफेयर यूज ऑफ पावर. इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन, transforming from an agrarian economy to modern economy based on setting up of large scale industries. Putty, indigo factories. Mahajan, money lender. Mortgage, money that you borrow in order to buy a house or flat on the security of some valuable things. The indigo uprising took place in India in 1859. In 18th century, England was going through industrial revolution. Industrial revolution, we had already discussed in the new term, means setting up of industries at large scale. At the same time, India was going through two phases, deindustrialization of India, and India was also treated a market for raw material. Deindustrialization of India means the industries of India were neglected by the British government, and India was treated as a market for raw material like cotton, jute and indigo. So export of indigo was a lucrative or profitable trade. The retired officers of East India Company set up indigo plantation in Bengal and Bihar. The indigo planters forced the peasants to grow the indigo instead of paddy or wheat. As a result, the peasants became foodless. These indigo planters measured 2.5 bigha as 1 bigha, and they gave low rate for indigo to peasants. So the peasants protested and they signed a mass petition. Petition means a written request. This petition was signed by Digambar and Vishnu Charan Biswas of Nadia, who were the local zamindars. Under the leadership of these two local zamindars, the boycott of indigo planting was started in Bengal in 1860. Soon the protest got the support of some renowned intellectuals like Harish Chandra Mukherjee and Deen Bandhu Mitra. Harish Chandra Mukherjee was editor and journalist of Hindu Patriot. Hindu Patriot was a leading English newspaper. Deen Bandhu Mitra published a novel called Neel Darpan, which was translated in English as Indigo Mirror, by Michael Madhu Sudan Datta, who was a Anglo-Indian, in the name of humanist Bishop James Long. So under the pressure of the peasants and the intellectuals, the British government set up the Indigo Commission in India. According to that, it was declared that no peasant would be forced to grow indigo against his wishes. Apart from the indigo uprising, the other issue was the Deccan Rights. The Deccan Rights took place in South India in 1875 by different tribal communities of peasants, and especially it was led by the Kunbi dynasty. The Kunbi peasants were not happy with the British because the peasants were oppressed by the British government and Mahajans or moneylenders. The British adopted Rayotwadi system. This we have already discussed in last lesson. Rayotwadi system was a system which was there directly between the peasants and the British government. Under the Rayotwadi system, fixed land revenue had to be paid by the peasants, and money lenders also used to exploit the peasants. They lend money at high rate of interest. The peasants have to mortgage the land to money lenders, and as a result there was transfer of land from peasants to money lenders. The Kunbi peasants socially boycotted money lenders in Pune and Ahmednagar, but in vain. It was not successful. Their protest was not successful, so they revolted against money lenders, and this revolt was led by a local leader called Kanglia. Then a Koa rebellion was also there in the eastern Godavari area of present Andhra Pradesh. It was led by a leader called Toma Dora. Under the pressure of the riots, the revolt started by the peasants, the British government passed the Deccan Land Act, which restrict the loan on mortgage of property and said that deed of contract in government offices was required. That means it was necessary to have a proper record of any transfer between the money lender and the peasants. If you want to discover more about on this topic, you should go through these YouTube links and try to go through these questions. What were the causes of the Indigo Revolt, and why did the authority introduce the Deccan Land Act? I hope you have understood till here. With the help of this explanation and internet, you are advised to make the note of the above topic. Thank you.